Welcome to the 2014 Christmas edition of my Allways patch collection video. This is a kind of traditional video I do every year on the Christmas day. So this year's collection isn't as big as my last one. Many buttons that I filmed last Christmas has been stored away at his and 12's house. They are still mine too, but I don't have space here, so they are stored away. But since I have stored away many buttons, I also have received some new buttons as well. Sorry, bumped my head into that. So let's begin with one of the classics. This generic elevator controller. I got it as a present back in 2011. It's a P-Dal S4 controller. Released sometimes in the 90s and still in production, I guess. It's a very reliable controller, and for a time there were many elevators installed using this controller, so it works quite well. And this one is just mine. Here's something new. At least the frame is new, the buttons are old. The buttons are received from Söderhallarna when a freight of it were Moderna Stint and Otis. So I saved these buttons. They were to lose spare parts. So I received the panel from Mörby Centrum with the cable behind that was connected to a Mörby's phone. This was an extra spare panel that never got any use and were left in the machine rooms. You can see that the sixth buttonhole is still missing. I think the sixth button is at his and 12's collection right now. But it will be fun to fill the hole with the number six button that I got. Here is one of the classics. It's my first ever collected button panel. It's a 1992 Thyssen button panel, which I received back in 2010 or 2011 when those elevators were announced by his group. Here we have a mix of new and old parts. The other panel I showed you it earlier. It is from Heden 124, I guess. I don't really remember the number, but it was the devaluators that was locked off inside. You receive new cab buttons from Kuhn and in the doors. So I managed to save this button panel upon request. Then we have Asir Graham buttons. It's from Hedhamre, also in Bollnäs, like the dev panel. Have call button, use light and directional lights. Very cool indeed. These buttons, Brandon Cooney, or DMG buttons, also gift from P-Dal, just like the controller. I never tried out if they actually works or not. Then we have floor indicator together with Otis with one down call and Otis cab car operating panel. They're all from this grey house behind the grey house in the front. All those Otis elevators has been modernized last summer by actually I don't remember who modernized it, but it became into generic. Still they works pretty well right now. Stay tuned for a modernization video coming up next year or sometime in the future, where I compare the old Otis elevator with its modernization. Now to another favorite. This is a kind of floor positioner. You know where elevator is, using these copper things. So when the elevator moves, the wheel around the thing will also move, telling the controller where the elevator is located at. I don't know which brand it is, but I think it is used among several elevator brands, even in Germany. But it is really interesting one. I got it from a person called Erik Berry, who left the world several years ago. He was an elevator enthusiast like me and collected buttons in a period between the 70s and 2000s. I had many buttons in his collection. And this one, I keep it into my own collection right now. Next, here you can see a relay controller system. It is made by Kune in 1980. I bought it off from a site called Tradera, which is a sister site of eBay, a Swedish variant of it. The seller claims that some relays are missing, but I cannot see where those blind spots really are. I also don't know how the relay really works, so I can't really fix this thing out really. Next, we have a Kune button panel, gifted by me from Gothenburg. Or it's not really a gift, I actually bought it off from someone in Gothenburg back in 2011. Next week is a really interesting floor diagram. I don't really know where it was used. It says Tyst Avsug from 1981. It was also from Erik Berry's collection. These two panels, branded as Hisshorn Unlifts, with MCS fixtures, used to light red. I got them off from a building nearby. I discovered that building the first time in June this year. And later on I wanted to try out my microphone in August this year. But I discovered that both the elevators were about to be modernized by them. So just like the Otis elevators, I followed up a modernization progress, visiting there many times, filling the elevators when they were under modernization. So I received these buttons as well. You should stay tuned for a modernization video comparison of the elevators sometime next year, so you can see how these buttons were really used and how these elevators look like today. These came out from a set of 1980 Kune traction elevators that were cab modernized in the 90s sometime by Hisshorn Unlift. And now they are modernized. And now let's see what I have here. A bunch of buttons. These are from Erik Berry's collection. From the left you have a Sierra Graham floor indicator showing basement ground on one with up and down arrows. In the middle we have Graham Brothers call buttons. And to the right we have an ASEA call button with directional and induced lights. We have a VLAN call and some down button together with induced light. And then we have a sign saying 3 persons 240 kilograms, kids under 12 years should not use this lift, written in Finnish, a gift from Finnish Lifts film in 1993. These three are from Erik Berry's collection. They're old Kune, these two are 1970s model and this is 1980s model. So I have a call button and a door open button together with a out of order light. And the two are directional lanterns. There are a couple of service signs. There are some very old and classic elevator signs. Emergency from a lift and the power switch signs. Kune call button, a gift from Heritage Elevators. Since I'm mixed and switching components between this elevator panel and this call button. Maximum load 102 grams. Graham Brothers call button. I washed it off and I accidentally washed off the up and down signs here, so they are not gone. They can easily be washed off, so better be careful about that. Sir Graham, it says down, up, in use, and ground here. Then you can call it and send it down if you want to. Next we have Stahl, his call button. Used to be a freight operator serving 6 floors. This is a DIV call button from Stockholm Central. This one was put together after I took apart everything. Most parts are in some of these boxes and the others are in that blue bag. It's very heavy. Here is a power switch. I don't have a fitting key for it, so I use the screws. Here I play with the D-call buttons. Where's the other part? And here's a Thyssen. And then we have a cooler. Gifted from Windelv. Finnish two-lift filmer, 1993. It's a floor indicator from Ekberg. These buttons near the monitor, I fix them up so they can light up. I think I filmed separate videos of these when I made that. But I don't really have time to wind these things up right now. So I have some more stuff to show you here. If this wasn't enough to satisfy yourself. DIV components, aspirin. Here's something else. Some Kuna spare patch from the same place as those came up from. Original 1980s call buttons, 1970s one. Floor Otis, man a spare patch. Here's a Kuna Noel floor indicator. Took it off from here. It's broken too. And man, another spare patch. All in all, I hope you enjoyed it as I did to make this one all together. I wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year, and we'll see all together soon enough. Here is an old, unused logbook. Normal people write down with faults and loggings on these logbooks, but this one is completely empty and has never been used. It's brand as Schlieren AB. Very interesting. Probably it has been used but never written down. Very interesting. reason. So I'm gonna use this one to press and try out. And look at this. It's a beautiful sight. It's something that I always wanted to try out. Very beautiful. Be careful to not touch the metallic covers on this. Watch this. Isn't that cool? So I'm gonna use this and let's see if it lights up when I push it. And yes, it does. Very cool, huh? Also nice from inside the core as well. That's really neat. Be careful with the side part because they are very exposed. So I'm gonna plug this thing off. And disconnect it from the market switch.